Today, we're gonna see if we can use water and science to make ice form on command. Welcome to Impossible Science. Hey everyone, it's Jason Latimer, world champion of magic, coming to you with another Impossible Science. Now today's topic,
supercooling.
Now supercooling is when a liquid drops below its freezing point, but it's still a liquid. A lot of people think that water's freezing point is 0 degrees Celsius or 32 degrees Fahrenheit. But that just means at that point, it can turn to ice, but doesn't mean it has to be ice. Imagine you're in a valley where the valley represents the liquid state, and you would be happier in the lower valley, which represents the ice state. But between you and that lower valley, there is a mountain. To make it from one state to another, you would have to put in energy to hike up and over that mountain barrier before arriving at the lower ice valley. The position you're in is the same as the water molecules in pure water. As the temperature is lowered below 0 degrees Celsius, the water molecules want to be in the lower valley, but the mountain represents the energy barrier needed from them to go from liquid to ice. However, we can reduce the size of this barrier between liquid and ice, either by lowering the temperature even more, or adding an impurity to the water, such as dust, or even adding a seed crystal to start the crystallization process. Adding any one of these to our situation would be like shrinking down the mountain barrier, or in some cases, they could act like a catalyst, tunneling through the mountain to reach the lower ice valley. Okay, now that we understand supercooling, the idea of freezing water on command becomes totally possible. And this is a bottle of supercooled water. We can tell because of the air pocket in there that this is still liquid. And I'm being really gentle with it because to get that nucleation event, all I have to do is strike the bottle. Freezing on command in 3, 2, 1. Isn't that crazy? You can see it just going all the way down. How cool is that? It froze so fast the bubbles got caught inside the ice. That is awesome. You how to do this. The first thing you want to do is get pure water. So next time you're at the store, get some bottled water. Then you need to put it in your freezer. I've seen a lot of people try to do this at home and they never know when their bottle's actually super cooled, but there's a trick to that. Take another one of those bottles, but fill it up with tap water and put the tap water, which has impurities in it, in the freezer next to the bottle with pure water in it. The impure water will actually freeze faster. So when that's a block of ice and the other one's still liquid, then you know the bottle with the pure water in it is super cooled. And then you're ready to go. It looks like magic. We just made an impossible topic of freezing an object on command. And we made it possible through science. And if you enjoy taking impossible topics and making them a reality, make sure you let me know. Click the like button, share the video with your friends. And if you try this at home, let me know in the comments below. And as always, if you want to learn more about my goofy experiments of taking impossible topics and making them a reality, make sure you subscribe to the channel. And until next time, stay curious, because the right question changes everything.